They are quote. Just
two
the two of them. You're right.
Yeah.
You were on top of the pops last week.
He'll have a record out next
week. What, that octopus?
Yeah, well,
he's great, isn't he?
Which better than some of us?
He's going
he's
into.
A good-looking boy, sort of.
He's a good looking boy. Yeah. He's got lovely eyes.
You know, he can get his whole body into that.
He apparently can get his whole body into that wine bottle because they've got no bones in them.
That's his eyes.
His eyes at the top there.
It looks a bit like a hippopotamus.
Lucky octopus, I say. Looks a bit ugly, I know.
You were frightened, weren't you? Because you thought we had him in here live.
Frightened? I was cacking myself. Yeah. I don't want to be in the room with one of those things. They've got too many bits and pieces hanging off them.
Anyway, congratulations, you
yeah,
two.
Yeah, congratulations
you.
On the
you
single.
Must be thrilled to bits, because I think one of the last times we spoke to you that you were really cheesed off about this radio business. That
Radio One.
Radio One. They wouldn't put you on the playlist.
It wasn't that. It was the thing that the press card went for, and it was something the focus went on, but it was another issue that we'd done a show for them for 125,000 people. And free of charge. So, and we went into a deal with them on the album for that show, and we had no problem necessarily not playing the records, or a slight problem. But then pay us for the show. That was part of the issue. And
life does go on after
exactly.
Radio 1, as we've
as
proved,
you've discovered.
I think.
What, I'll tell you what, I don't quite get. I mean, sometimes myths attach themselves to people in the public eye, and you cannot shake them off. For example, Fergie never had her toes sucked, not on camera. You show me a photo of Fergie actually having her toe sucked. It does not exist. What you have is a photograph of a bloke, a financial advisor, kissing the sole of her foot, not sucking her toes. Big difference.
There isn't.
Of course there is.
He's still. If he's a financial advisor, I'm a toe sucker.
Having her.
All right, bundle.
Hang on. No, let's just nail this. Let's just nail this.
This is foreplay for these two. This is what it is.
Obsessive. So, look, it said Fergie famously having her toe sucked.
Yeah,
papers.
She
had the heel of her foot kissed. Right, now, status quo only ever play three chords.
Yeah.
Rubbish.
Yeah.
Nonsense.
It is, yeah.
Nonsense. And yet, I read nice articles about you recently. I mean, you know, articles saying that you're great and they like you, but famously they can only play three chords. That would drive me mad.
Well, thing about it is, it's a tag, and I suppose these days it's kind of good to be tagged with anything, you know, that kind of describes you. Yeah. And I think it's fair to say that as soon as any Quo record starts, no matter how many chords there are in there, you know it's Quo straight away. There's something about the sound. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So, I mean, really and truly, I suppose some years ago, we would get a little hung up about it, but not these days, you know, it doesn't matter.
Because I suppose it's not meant unkindly.
No, I don't think so.
But, well, okay, fine.
It's very tongue-in-cheek. You know.
Yeah, yeah. But it's not true.
It is something about this country.
And a half.
It is something about this country, though, isn't it? I mean, even Mick Jagger gets it. You know, I mean, he's past a certain age, and he's a lot older than you two.
Uncle Mick.
What?
Uncle Mick, we call him.
Uncle Mick, yeah.
Or Auntie Mick.
Another
Mick.
Thing.
He is ridiculed for still being a very good lead vocalist who goes on tour.
But the thing is, anybody that goes into anything, we've done lots of promo and interviews in the last few weeks, and most of them say that kind of thing, and you always say to these people, well, when you want to be a writer, did you decide to be a writer for a few months, or did you want to do it as a career?
Yeah.
And we wanted it as a career. Yeah. And plus, with the change of the music, we didn't necessarily want to change the music. No one goes to B.B. King and says, well, you play blues all the time. You just punch your lights out. That's what he does.
Yeah.
You know, we do things. This is what we do. We're not saying it's rocket science. It's what we do.
Is it because when you know, rock and roll really, really kicked off in this country in the 60s. Obviously, it was youth-led. And so it was expected that it would always have the youth image. Is it that?
It was in its infancy then, wasn't it? And to me, if we got to today and there were no older bands around, it would mean that our parents' generation were correct. It had no validity, it didn't have any substance to it, and it should be a short-lived thing. Mm. It isn't. Music is for everybody. It isn't for any age at all. It doesn't mean that we can't like a record by a 17-year-old or a 20-year-old and they can't like records by a 40-year-old. In fact, we teach our children classical music, which is hundreds of years old. We tell them that's good, but then there's
some in that as well.
A lot of those, yeah.
Certainly in Vivaldi, there's a few simple chord changes.
So you've got the new album's out on Monday, isn't it?
Correct.
Heavy Traffic.
Heavy Traffic, yeah. Right. And it's got Jam Side Up.
Down.
Down.
Down. On it. Yeah.
Sorry.
Got Jam Side Up in it.
Got Jam Side Up down
that's
in it.
That one's on it, yeah.
In it. And that's what you're going to be playing for us at the
yes, we are, yeah.
at the end of the show.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Right. And the CD, what is it? Just It's not greatest hits or
no,
anything.
No, it's all original.
It's all new album. Yeah.
It's the first studio album for, what, 2.5?
3 years, yeah.
3 years, something like that. And we're very, very pleased with it. I mean, genuinely pleased with this one. It's probably the best album we've ever made.
Right.
It's called Heavy Traffic's out on Monday. Sorry, I had to do that.
How are you? Anyway, you're keeping well.
You mean his ticker?
I'm very well.
Yeah, your heart, is it good?
Yeah, I'm very well. I kind of saw it as a midlife service, really, you know. Got that far. Now let's carry on. You know,
that's a hell of a service.
So I'll stick with no problem. Touch wood.
Yeah. And why were you so, without going into too much detail, so self sort of deprecatory about your bedroom performance over the years? Recently, I read you said that you know.
I didn't say that. Somebody else said that.
He was misquoted.
Oh, was it a misquote?
It's just stuff they say. You just do it, and I get it's silly, really. I love sex. I've got 8 kids. I know how to do it. I'm good at it. I'm in there for seconds, me. I don't mess about.
Before we do something we want you to judge here for us, this documentary, we just saw a clip of it there at the beginning. Mm. It seems, is it like warts and all?
Oh, very warty.
Access all areas?
Yeah.
Well, they catch you sort of after the gig. I mean, it was a kind of tricky thing to do, really, because there's enough pressure when you're on tour anyway, other than having a camera crew with you all the time. Mm. But they were a fantastic crew, and Jane Trias, who produced it, they're just great to work with, and they got us after the show and really how we feel after the show sometimes, you know, and first thing in the morning, literally, when you get out of bed, they're there.
Yeah.
And so it's captured a lot of what people don't actually see.
I mean, you with the hump, really, is what
it is. Well, you were the hump, you said.
Big time,
you saw it last night.
You
call it the hump. I was showing you the
hump. It's being nice, we call it the hump, yeah.
Well, did you see the Rolling Stones one that I think Chris Evans did about a year or so back, and it had a lot of stuff with them backstage before they go on concert, they're on their world tour. And what I thought was quite endearing, they were quite nervous when they went on. Mm. They used to put their arms around each other as they walked down the corridor to go on stage, you know, and they've been doing it for 30, 40 years.
That's just so they won't hit each other. We've passed that stage.
I think a lot of bands have this kind of ritualistic thing before they go on.
We don't get nervous.
I think you've got to have a certain amount of nervous energy in you because it's fair to say sometimes before we go out on stage, I mean, for whatever reason, we're a bit tired or whatever, as soon as you hit that stage, something happens. And I know what it is. But.
Well, listen, looking forward to hearing you later on.
You are my destiny.